This is truly a special time in Sawyer's Creek. As many of you remember, a few years back, we had the pleasure of being able to play bells that were donated to us for a Christmas service, and we were able to use those bells for about 2 years. They were donated for use by Shiloh Baptist Church. And it was such a joy and a ministry, and it has been a hope that we would be able to purchase some bells for our church. And if you know anything about handbells, they are extremely expensive. And someone heard our call, and it's Paige and Beth, both are active here in this church. Glenwood Friends, which is a church in Greensboro, donated their bells. And they're representative of so many churches across the state and the nation. They're unable to keep their attendance up. And knowing this, they chose, rather than to put their bells in a closet, they chose to share their ministry. And so it's really a legacy that's continuing on, and I think it's an example of good Christian love, and that, you know, music is a ministry. There's many ways that we minister, whether it be through action, through song, through words. And what a blessing that they have chosen to donate these bells to us so that we can continue a legacy that they started. And I'm going to let Paige, I think she can explain a little bit more about some of the history of it.
The bells we will be playing this morning were a gift from Glenwood Friends Meeting, a Quaker church in Greensboro, North Carolina. This is the church my mom and grandmother grew up in. My mom and dad were also married at Glenwood. When my grandmother comes to visit, she attends this church with us, and during these times, she has seen me play in the junior bell choir. So one day, a few months ago, she asked me if the church would enjoy some brass handbells. As soon as I could, I went to Miss Lynn and asked her if she would teach us how to play some songs on the bells. So I hope y'all enjoy the song we will be playing.
The part that she left out is when Beth actually came, we were played Christmas play practice, and she said, "Lynn, we have bells that are being donated." And I'm thinking, these bells. I'm thinking these. And I'm like, "No, we have enough." And she said, "No, I mean real bells, real bells." And I nearly had a heart attack. That's not a gift that a church gets every day. So we are so blessed. And thank you. And please share with your mother how much we are so blessed and we are appreciative of what they've done.
Thank you. I believe it appropriate if we stand to do our responsive reading, so please stand with me once again if you're able. As I said before, this responsive reading is designed to dedicate these handbells to the worship of Jesus Christ at Sawyer's Creek Baptist Church. Psalm 33 encourages the singing and playing of music in worship of the Lord. Sing joyfully to the Lord, you righteous.
It is fitting and upright to praise him.
Sing to him a new song. For the word of the Lord is right and true.
He is faithful in all he does.
The Lord loves righteousness and justice. In Exodus 28, God designs the Old Testament priest's garment. Make the robe entirely of blue cloth with an opening for the head in its center. Make pomegranates of blue, purple, and scarlet yarn around the hem of the robe with gold bells between them. The gold bells and the pomegranates are to alternate around the hem of the robe. Aaron must wear it when he ministers. The sound of the bells will be heard when he enters the holy place before the Lord, and when he comes out, so that he will not die. Lord, creator of metal and music, we thank you for allowing us the freedom to worship you in many ways. Lord, Redeemer of the world, we thank you for preparing us a place in heaven where our praises will be perfect. Ending.
May
Lord, sanctifier of the church, we thank you for providing the church with musicians and contributors to enrich our worship to your glory. Lord, be pleased to accept these handbells, which we bring before you, to be used for your glory.
Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.